fancy skin. What are you thinking? I feel, I don't know. I don't know. I gotta just develop my feelings on it. But we are about to go to the nail shop. And then hopefully I can find somewhere to get my car washed. But I am starting very late in the day. It's like 3:52. And one of these things needs to get accomplished, my nails being one of them. So hopefully everybody got out because it's beautiful today, 81 degrees. Hopefully everyone got out early today. Oh, adjusting my mirror. Got out early today and left room for me to do what I need to do. So, yeah. Cute. This is a Forever 21 version of the Frankie Shop shoulder pad muscle tee. I have on some shorts. I'm carrying my Fendi crossbody. And then I also have on my Fendi slides and the Nicki Minaj Fendi earrings. I was kind of like, is that too much Fendi? But it's you know, it's proportioned. So the earrings sit here, the bag sits at my waist, and then the shoes are all the way down to my feet. So I think it's okay. Got my little Rolex on, this is my Tiffany ring. These are just some little stack rings that I got from Forever 21. My Cartier, a nail head ring, and then my Chanel ring. This bracelet is a gift that I got from my ex-husband, and this is the Etsy version of the Cartier thing. So fragrance that I have on, every, just for your information, I'm not a fragrance girl, but I like to smell good. My base is always going to be the male version of Issey Miyake. That stuff just does something to me on the inside. I call it the baby maker. Like, if a man, I don't care how ugly he is, if his natural body juice mixes well with the Issey Miyake, he could probably get it. Not necessarily for me, but I'm just saying it, that's how good it smells to me. And then I topped it off with Gucci Bamboo. My nose is running. And I have my tripod, so I'm hoping I can get a picture for the Instagram, because I haven't posted in, I think, like almost two weeks now. So, all right, let's hit it.
I'm pausing right here to let you know that we're rewinding just a little bit so I can tell you and show you how I pulled this face together. Then we'll get back to the other clips of the vlog.
Hey you, welcome or welcome back to my channel. It's me, LD. If we don't know each other quite yet, you don't feel comfortable calling me LD, my name is Ladessa. So what I need for you to do, if you would be so kind, is hit that subscribe button, then hit that notification bell button so you know when all of my uploads are uploaded. We get to know each other down in the comment section. I also have Instagram. Go ahead and follow me here if you would also be so kind. So the sponsor for today's video is Your Skin But Better. Skin tints are all the rage right now. No one's really doing full coverage, which is like, okay, but we want full coverage. I don't know. We're embracing, you know, what's happening underneath here before we put something on it, but we also want to kind of touch those imperfections, but it looks like skin. So anyway, with that being said, getting on the skin tint bandwagon, I had to try out the new Fenty Skin, but I wanted to see how it would perform on mature skin. So I'm going to do my entire routine, you know, powder, setting, concealer, bronzer, all of that, but using the Fenty Skin as my base. And this video is pretty much going to be all Fenty. So the Fenty skincare line, as well as the Fenty makeup. So if you want to see how I pulled this together and how it's going to perform on mature skin, then let's hang over to the other side.
Right now, I'm using the Fenty Cleanser. I know when it first came out, people were discussing the fragrance to it. To me, it doesn't smell too strong. I actually like it. It's pretty much a mild fragrance to me, but I actually really like the cleanser. It doesn't really get all of the makeup off as it says, but it's cool. And I don't cleanse my face, or dry my face rather, with a towel. I always use paper towels just to keep my skin as clean as possible from the dyes and stuff that are in towels. I'm about to go in now with the Fenty Fat Water. I could take it or leave it, but I bought it, so I use it occasionally. It's all right. It's more of a gel base, which is kind of cool to me, but I don't really feel like it completely tones my my skin, but it's cool. The moisturizer, on the other hand, that is my jam. I love the way it makes my skin feel. I feel really, really hydrated. Not dewy. It's not a dewy finish, but it leaves my skin so plump, so hydrated. I love this moisturizer. Riri did that with this one. Now I'm just doing my lymphatic drainage routine, just trying to, you know, even out the skin and give it a nice little massage. Here I am applying the Fenty lip balm. It's actually cool. A little pricey for a lip balm, but it's cool. Gives the palette a nice little something something. I shared with you in my makeup routine for mature skin video that I don't use color shadows anymore. I'm pretty much a neutral girl. So here I'm just using the Mocha Mommy bronzer and Penny For You Thoughts as my shadow. I do have one of her Click or Stack or whatever shadows that she came out with, but I don't like it. I don't really think they're very good. Like, I don't get really good pigmentation payoff. And even the shimmer that's in it, even with my finger, I can't get a good application. But using the bronzer and the highlighter as a shadow paid off really good. So you'll see at the end of the video that I got a nice little cute, mature, neutral look. I'm speeding through this primer routine. I'm using the Hydrating Fenty Primer. But if you want a more detailed step-by-step of what I use when I'm priming my skin before applying my foundation, or in this case, skin tint, make sure you check out my flawless makeup routine for mature skin. I'll leave it in the cards. Yes, our sponsor is Your Skin But Better. But I am not a fan of the discoloration or hyperpigmentation. Is it hyper or hypo? I don't know. But the dark marks around my mouth. So I still color correct, even though I may be using like a BB cream, CC cream, or in this case, a skin tint. And I'm using the shade 20 in this. And I am going to be applying it with my hands as Riri instructed we should. I've seen some ladies use a brush, but I wanted to demo it the way it was demoed for us all. So you'll see here, I am using a brush just to shear things out on my forehead and also make sure that my brows are, you know, still sculpted out. I'm also going in with just a little bit more of the skin tint in my smile lines where I apply the MAC Paint Pot, just to make sure that that's fully covered and not peeking through. I'm not too mad at it. I think I'm liking how it's looking so far. I don't know where I went. Where are you at, LD? The people are waiting on you. I'm back. I think I'm getting ready to go in with the concealer now. Let's see. Oh, nope. I'm fixing my lash and making sure that that's secure. Now, what are we doing? Now I'm going in with my concealer. I'm using the Fenty Concealer in the shade 390. It's kind of close to my skin tone, so I am going to go in with a, I already showed you and told you, going in with a lighter shade of concealer. It is the Makeup Revolution hydrating concealer. Now I'm getting ready to sculpt out the face with the Mocha Mommy bronzer. It's a little red, but I like it. Now that I really know how to bronze, I like it. I had initially had got, I think, like Caramel Cutie, and it was just a little too light. So I used that as a shadow as well. And I'm going to let the concealer sit. Am I? No. Yes, I am. Underneath my eyes, I blended it out. So here I'm using the Fenty Cream Blush. Not a big fan of it. I guess I probably just need to learn how to use it a little better. It just, I don't know. It just didn't do anything for me. So now I am just marrying everything together, blending in my bronzer, making sure not to get it in my adult hairs. Now I'm blending out my concealer after it's set for a little bit. Just making sure I get as much coverage as I possibly can underneath the eyes. And yeah, I'm going in with the Fenty setting powder in Nutmeg, and I'm going to mix it with my all-time favorite setting powder by Too Faced. It's the Peach Perfect. It just gives me everything I need as it relates to setting my face and the foundation and everything. And I do like the Fenty setting powder. It can be a little drying, so that's why I use the Peach Perfect, which is supposed to be a matte setting powder, but to me it's a little hydrating. Like I don't feel like it, sucks the life out of me. Now I'm going over that cream blush with some Milani blush, just 'cause like I said, I don't like the cream blush as of yet. And what are we doing now, Ladesta? Oh, adding a little highlight, and that's not a Fenty product. Now I'm just kind of marrying everything together to have a seamless look, spraying it down with some matte setting spray from Pretty Vulgar and also the Fenty facial mist. I don't know if that's really a setting spray. I have to look at the bottle, but we're all familiar. I'm smiling at you. My camera stopped because my memory card was full, but now we're getting back into the vlog. Okay, y'all, I'm in the car. So here is the Fenty Skin in natural light, no filter. I'm feeling I look a little red, so I probably should have got a lighter color. Let me come where it's not so much light. Because it oxidizes, and I know that was my problem with the original Fenty, the matte one. I should have got matte anyway, but I was trying to follow people that I think are my foundation twins, and I got 420, and it was just crazy, but not too bad. We'll see how it wears throughout the day. This is just an hour after putting it on. Yeah, probably about an hour. But so far so good. Not mad, just a little, like I said, I feel like I'm a little red, but other than that, is my lash coming down? Oh, no. All right. So, yeah. This is natural light, so you can see my pores and the texture I have, but it looks good. Yeah, so I tried to go take some photos on my Chi-Town is also known as the Windy City. So yeah, the wind was not letting me be great. It kept knocking down my tripod. So I don't know if I'm gonna get a photo today, which I'm kind of pissed about. But maybe I'm closer to the lake, so maybe once I get out to the south suburbs, maybe I'll have better luck. And then this old lady gonna say to me, well, why would you try to pose for the camera? Or no, what she say, why you try to strike a pose and you know it's windy outside and you know it's gonna knock it down? And I'm like, first of all, mind your own beeswax. Second of all, I want to take a picture because I look cute. So yeah, all right, well, I just wasted 20 minutes doing that, and now you probably couldn't even hear me because of the wind. Yeah, so I wasted 20 minutes doing that to get nothing. So, yeah. My stomach is growling, but I can't eat right now. I'm not, because I'll be tempted to eat something that is not good for me, and that's not gonna work. So, yeah. All right, y'all, well, onward and upward. I didn't bring anything to blot, and I can see I'm gonna be breaking up soon. All right, y'all, I'm frustrated. All right, so we just left the nail shop. Nails done. I got my car washed, but I couldn't go to a place where they could do the inside, which is what really needs to be done. So next we're going to stop by Walmart. Target is actually really across the street, but everything I need to do is on this side of the street. So I want to go to, I'm going to Walmart because I need some sanitary napkins, TMI. And then I have to, go to Home Depot because they owe me a refund, but they couldn't refund it to my debit card or, you know, over the phone or whatever. So have to go there. And then I want to get a budget book just so I can really, you know, in writing, look at my finances. And what else do I need to get? Oh, I need to get some paper towels for my face. I'm gonna put y'all on because I don't use a towel to dry my face. I use paper towels, but there's some paper towels that are chef's kiss when doing your skincare routine. Someone is calling me. Oh, all right, y'all. Uh-oh, let me turn this air down. Okay, so I had got a phone call. But yeah, I wanna get a budget book, and I seen one in Home Goods, and it was like $16, which is, you know, not a problem, but I didn't want to pay 16. I'd rather pay like $9. And I could use like one of my journals, but I just feel, you know, I feel a little more motivated if there's line items broken down for me. So that's what I'm gonna do. I need to get the towels for my face. I need to get sanitary napkins, and yeah, that's it really. So then Home Depot, and then I need to get something to eat, and I don't want to wait till I get home, so probably gonna have to do like a Chick-fil-A. Okay, you know, here's a better, I got the mask outline, but here's a better look of the makeup after about 3 hours. What time is it? Yeah, it's probably been about 3 hours. So it's wearing good, and it's actually wearing really good under my mask. I'm wearing a it's a cotton mask. It's actually a really good mask I took from my dad. So let me get closer so you can see. So yeah, other than I think everybody probably gets shiny. Turn this off. Shiny around their nose, but yeah. Okay, Fenty skin. And I'm still looking like skin. I mean, because I have the bronzer and blush and highlighter on, you can tell that I have makeup on. But as far as the base is concerned, I'm not mad. So let's go into Wally World. I hate coming into Walmart, but I'm so like irky. Like if what I have to do is on the same side of the street, then I prefer to stay on that side of the street. Also like with the gas station, like I could be running on E, but if the gas station is not on the path that I'm on, I'll push it till I get to where I'm going. All right, so let's go into Walmart. This is the mask that I have. So, I mean, there's some makeup in it, but not too bad considering. All right, so let's go. With the mask, do you guys do a full face or you just do your eyes and your forehead? I can't just halfway do it. I have to do everything. So, all right.
Reason 1,000,011 why I hate going to fucking Walmart. I go into Walmart, as I shared with you in the last clip, I come out and somebody hit my motherfucking car. And of course the motherfucker did not leave a note. If I'd have took my ass to Target, I wouldn't have this problem. This is the end of the vlog. I love you. Pack light, strut, slay. I'll see you next time. Bye.